good.
Yes.
Now you just lean it on his everlasting arms this morning. How many of you know that his everlasting arms will reach your situation? Wherever you are, might be in your sick room. You might be in your prayer closet. He can reach your sick. You might need some down in your Bible, but whether he can reach down in that sick. Thank you.
not by fear.
And not by fear.
I trust God.
I trust God.
To meet all of my needs.
To meet all of my needs.
Desires.
Desires.
And to strengthen.
And to strengthen.
My weaknesses.
My weaknesses.
I am growing.
I am growing.
In wisdom.
In wisdom.
Daily.
Daily.
I love people.
I love people.
All kinds of people.
All kinds of people.
Good people.
Good people.
Bad people.
Bad people.
Rude people. Church people.
Church people.
Family members.
Family members.
Co-workers.
Co-workers.
I love them all.
I love them all.
I have the heart of God.
I have the heart of God.
So I love people.
So I love people.
Save.
Save.
You will not.
You will not.
Deceive.
Deceive.
Use.
Use.
Or influence.
Or influence.
My thoughts.
My thoughts.
My actions.
My actions.
Nor my attitude.
Nor my attitude.
Because I have the heart of God.
I love people.
No matter what.
No matter what.
They say to me.
They say to me.
Their lack of response to me.
Their lack of response to me.
What they do to me.
What they do to me.
Even if it's intentional.
Even if it's intentional.
I'm gonna love them anyway.
I'm gonna love them anyway.
Lord help me.
Lord help me.
To love people.
To love people.
In their best.
In their best.
Like you love me.
Like you love me.
In mine.
In mine.
Amen.
Amen.
Let's give love in the house.
All right. Now we'll have a poem by Miss Jasmine Suggs.
Okay. Here we go. It's called The Perfect Church. And it reads, I think that I shall never see a church that's all it ought to be. A church whose members never stray from the straight and perfect narrow way. A church that has no empty pews and pastor never gets the blues. A church whose deacons are always deep and none are proud, but all are meek. A church that never gossips or lies. One that makes no complaints or criticize. Where all is all sweet and kind and all others' faults are blind. Such perfect churches, there may be, but let me let y'all know, they don't exist to me. But still, we will work, pray, and plan to make New Covenant the best church that we can.
Hey! Now we will have the history of the church, Destiny Heard.
In the beginning, God created man and woman. A man called Roderick, and a woman called Carol. Through talks and a love for God's word, there was a formed Keep It Real Bible study, including Roderick, Carol, Andre, Jared, and Cheryl. In 2002, our Bible studies were Monday nights in Fultondale at the home of Carol Davis, not religion. Many talks about the word and the world took place in that living room. May 29th, 2004, Roderick and Carol married, and 6 months later, God called Roderick to start a ministry. This is announced as after Thanksgiving dinner, and Roderick's now wife, Mama Carol, was in shock. This ministry will be called New Covenant of Faith, founded on 2 Corinthians 5:17 and Isaiah 43:18-19, with the theme being, there is a new life in Christ. November 28, 2004, Roger became Pastor Rod, and the first Sunday service was at Mama Chia's place of business in Pratt City. Through the ladybugs and the other bugs, we made it. Until that day, we got a call saying the building has been sold, and we need to be out with all our items removed by the next day. Our prayer was, Lord, let there be light. Please show us what's next. Next service was held in a banquet room off of Green Springs Avenue at the Howard Johnson Hotel. We were there for approximately 1 year. Then we were blessed with a storefront building on Carson Road. Many memories in this place, great services, weddings, baby showers, bridal showers, and let's not forget the famous fellowships out there, dinner and fun. Y'all know we like to eat. fun and educational Bible studies, plays, and we even made CDs of our messages. Then shortly after, we were able to obtain the building next to us, which became our children's church. 2011, we started our very first women's conference called Women Under Construction, and continued the next year with Women Walking with God. Change was coming, and it truly was our faith walk. In 2013, Pastor Rod told ministers to preach only about faith. In 2015, we started a lease purchase for Arthur School, which took a lot of work, and lots of faith was needed. But it just didn't work out, which means it just wasn't meant for us. In between our temporary holding place was Just State Center. In 2017, we moved into our present location, and the faith and work continues. Yeah.
Come on. I need someone, so I'm too young. God for Pastor Thomas and St. Andrew's family. Thank you so much for celebrating with us year 15. Appreciate you so very much. Appreciate you being a part of this day. We spent the last 15 years. Let me get my wife up here too. Come on back. We spent the last 15 years doing ministry work that we believed in.
It's been a learned experience, a growing experience, but we love what we do.
Amen. Let me, Brother Dre, come here. You and your wife, will you come up here? I want you guys to know how much I appreciate the support from you guys from day one all the way to right now. Amen. Mr. and Ms. Roy. I just want y'all got to stand up. But the absolute most faithful members, between them two and my mother, the absolute most faithful members at New Covenant, like you would not believe, at 83 and 26. The absolutely most faithful. When we got here this morning, 83 and 16. And whenever I preach, even if I go home and I feel like I done preached a bad message, my mama called me and said, "Boy, you showing up preach today." But she know me and she know that I like the reinforcement. It's good for me. So I thank you, Mother, for being so very faithful to New Covenant and to the ministry here. To everybody.